Hi y'all, welcome to linuxnix.com YouTube channel. Today we are going to see how to record your terminal session. That is nothing but whatever commands you are going to execute or executed. You can view them in a text format. Normally this can be done by using history command, but history command disadvantage is you cannot see what is the output of that command, and it's a kind of video kind of thing. You cannot see through history command. You can just see the commands what you executed till this point. So let us start with our script command to record your screen. In order to record your screen, type the script command, then the file where you want to save your recordings. Say I want to keep my recording file in temp folder. The extension doesn't matter. You can keep any extension. If you see, it says that the script file just got started and it started recording your terminal session. So suppose I'm going to give some of the commands which I use frequently. Now I'm going to stop my script command by typing exit, or you can press even Ctrl D to exit the script file. If you see, it says that script done, file is temp/record.txt. In order to see that file, you can use cat command and see the content. We can see the whatever the content it's having. See, till this point I executed, these are the commands which I executed. See, it started at Tuesday 06 December 2012. For the first command which I executed is pwd. You see, it goes on with the commands actually. But how to show in a video format? I mean, whenever I'm typing, how much time I'm taking to type the next command? It's not showing at all. It's just giving the command and its output. Command and its output. I want to see in a real time fashion, like someone is actually executing some commands right now. For that, we have to use script replay command to do that one. So even for that activity to take place, we have to even run the script command one more time. So before that one, I'll remove my understanding purpose. I'm removing my recorded file. Then I'm going to start new script. Script hyphen T for timestamp, A for appending. This is for redirecting that timestamp and other things to the files. This is my timestamp time.txt, and this is my recording session .temp/record.txt. Now my recording just got started. You can see the difference, previous one and this one. I'm just executing some dummy commands. Perl 5. I just executed some of the commands. Now I'll exit this script file. That's it. The script file got created. Now I'll try to run my script replay script command. Script replay. Then what is my timestamp which I used? TMP time.txt. And what is my recorded timestamp? TMP record. If you observe, from this point onwards I am not going to type anything. I'll move my mouse. You can see that someone is typing the commands. If you see it's just starting up. Yeah, I didn't execute this ls command, which is already recorded in my record.txt actually. Again, these things are previously recorded actually. So how beautiful it is. So it's just showing me how I previously executed these commands. That's it. I'm going to press exit now. That's it. It got exited. I think I even run this pinging of google.com. That's it. This is this much simple. It's your script command and script reply. Thanks for watching my videos on YouTube. Keep visiting linuxnix.com for more updates, and scripting.linuxnix.com for shell scripting tutorials and tips. Happy Linux.